Hey everyone, I'm George Katsiopoulos and welcome to the Billboard Magazine Hollywood Reporter Annual Pride Summit. The LGBTQ community has certainly had its share of obstacles, and while not being able to physically celebrate Pride together is the least of our worries, it's still not going to stop us. Pride is not canceled, and I'm so thankful we're able to band together to virtually celebrate. Here's my friend Paige Muller, who is the VP of Unscripted at Hello Sunshine. I love Paige because she's a wonderful ally and cheerleader for the LGBT community, and she really loves to get dressed up. Paige is always very chic and elegant, but she really knows how to have fun. Her clothing choices are pretty classic, but her favorite color is also leopard. I thought this very simple black column gown would be great for her to emphasize her curves, and its simplicity was just screaming for a really, really big moment. I picked up this rainbow cape at the party store, and you know, I just thought this gave this a wow factor, and Paige added even more to it with her red lip. I love a cape. It's like going out wrapped in a blanket, and it, you know, kind of makes you feel like a superhero. I think it's the best. Here are my friends Katasi Kalubya, who is a lead product designer at Disney, and her partner Felicia Dalton, who is a math teacher at Windward School. But do not worry, Felicia will not be chaperoning today. I always love how Tassi looks. You know, she veers on the softer side of androgynous. She showed up in this great black double-breasted blazer, skinny trousers, and the perfect black patent shoes. But I thought it would be great to give her a more formal look, so I lent her one of my white shirts and a bow tie. I thought it would be a cute homage to those adorable couples who get all matchy-matchy for their proms, so I pulled out this electric blue bow tie, which I actually wore for my first Emmy's red carpet appearance, just to match the color of Felicia's slip dress. Felicia veers more femme with her dressing, but it's silly to define someone, you know, just in one way. Felicia has an edge, so I lent her my motorcycle jacket and gave her some shocking pink earrings for fun. We even added the pink star for an asymmetrical look and also a nod to what the girls in the 80s were doing when I was in high school. I think they look fabulous, and I think they're gonna win cutest couple. Olin's look is for the kind of person who doesn't like to wear a lot of color and might be a little bit more reserved. Some people, gay or straight, are just not into wearing bright colors. And that's fine, but this is a great way to participate and still feel comfortable. None of this applies to Olin, of course, by any means. He's just a model today. But his look just shows how you can make a huge statement with just one simple accessory like this colorful tie. Mason McCulley is my actor friend who is absolutely not afraid of getting dressed up. Mason showed up with this super fun sequin blazer that he bought and had never worn, and when he tried it on, I thought it looked perfect with what he was already wearing. So many people want to be super comfortable at formal events and just wear their jeans and sneakers, but honestly, you can't do this because it's important to elevate your look for many, many reasons. First of all, if you show up to a party and everyone is dressed fabulously, you're certainly going to experience some major FOMO. I mean, I know I have been there. Not to mention it's poor etiquette. Your hosts invited you with a specific dress code in mind, so it is a little rude to not even make an attempt, you know, to participate. My sweet friend Claudia Lee is a fearless actress, and I did two looks on Claudia because, you know, this is what she does. She professionally becomes different people, and I just couldn't stop her. Like many youngsters in their early 20s, Claudia is obsessed with all things 90s. She picked up this purple sparkly vintage dress last week. Yes, 90s are vintage now. And I thought it would be perfect for Pride Prom. We wanted to give it a bit of edge, so I gave her my 70s vintage denim vest and added a bedazzled biker keychain around her neck. Claudia's other look is a vintage one-shoulder rainbow dress from the 70s that was knee-length, but we tucked it under as a micro-mini to make it more modern. Claudia loves to dance, so she was happy to wear old-school sneakers. Plus, the sneakers were a nice balance with the super girliness of the dress. Think Kristen Stewart really on any red carpet. She is a perfect example of someone who dresses as their authentic self while still wearing what's appropriate for the event. I think she has great style and she is always true to herself. This is my really good friend Todd Hawkins, who is managing partner and co-founder of Hawkins Makita, a social impact firm. They advise celebrities and entertainment brands and executives on their philanthropic and political strategies. Todd also works with LGBTQ organizations to advance equality and justice, and he's a national board member of the Human Rights Campaign. Todd is more preppy than flashy, but he was willing to get out of his comfort zone for Pride Prom. Todd is not prone to wearing really bold, bright colors, but he is certainly not afraid of them. And thank God, because he looks amazing in them. I saw the perfect shirt for under Todd's suit on the rack, And it just happened to be from the women's department. It used to be for the last few decades that it was socially acceptable for women to wear men's clothing, but not vice versa. And boy, has that changed. It's wonderful that now there are shops that you can just walk into and they don't direct you to one side or the other. You know, it's more like, shop wherever you like, you know, anything goes. This is Haley Prokos, who is a journalist, and she also happens to be my adoring niece. Her look is more a mashup of a bunch of different styles that harkens back to prior decades. It's all about the 80s and 90s for these youngsters, and for Haley, that means bicycle shorts, bustiers, and blazers. Her cobalt blue power blazer is straight off of an episode of Designing Women. Her earrings are a little bit like Melanie Griffith in Working Girl, but before she met Harrison Ford. And her bustier and biker shorts are kind of like, you know, Madonna, a little bit Demi Moore at the Academy Awards. You guys remember that look? She made it herself. But the icing on the cake are her fabulous metallic rainbow pumps. Remember, just a couple of accessories can take your look just over the edge. For my look, lately I've been obsessed with wearing any type of suit as a shorts suit, even to a formal event. I just think it's more fun and it's a little bit irreverent. So Pride Prom, for me, could have been about bold colors, but I'm making it about bling because I really wanted to wear one of the ties from my new collection that I'm doing with my friend Laura Bossi, who is this fabulous designer, couture designer, and tailor to the stars. So we're taking these vintage designer ties, meticulously hand-beating them, and, you know, making something that was kind of useless into something that's fabulous. Whenever I wear one of our ties, I'm always stopped at parties, and I gotta be honest, I love the attention. We are dressing for ourselves, but you know, who doesn't love people coming up to you and telling you how fabulous you look? I really, really hope that all of these tips, you know, help you feel fabulous. And hey, if you get some adoring fans on the way, then it's just an added bonus. Thank you so much to Billboard and The Hollywood Reporter for having me today, and I hope that you guys have a fabulous time at the Pride Prom.